Welcome, my dear students, for part 3, topic Applied History. Let us take a short review of what we have seen in the previous video. We have seen what is Applied History. We have seen importance of Applied History. We have seen the correlation of history with various subjects. We have also seen preservation of cultural heritage. We have also seen the various world heritage which is announced by UNESCO. Now let me conclude the lesson. Now the question arises in our mind, if I learn history, can I pursue any profession in my life? Will it be helpful professionally? As it already been said in the first part, that history is just not the event of the past, but this can be applied in our life. You know, we can say history can give you bread and butter. Now, my dear students, we will see now what are the different professions that can be pursued through history. As it has already been said, that the knowledge of history can be supportive in the decision making with regards to respective legal provisions and public policies in the following fields. First one, museum and archives. When I say museum, you can work as a museum curator. That is how history is helping you. If I say archives, if you have the old historical things with you, you can have your private museums. Second thing, what are the other professions? You can pursue as a historian to preserve and conserve historical sites in your local area or in a city. Third, you can pursue tourism. You can be a good tourist guide if you have a great knowledge of history of your locality. Not only tourism, but also hospitality. You can see, if you go to a tourist place, you need a place to stay. So what we do? We go to a 5-star hotel or a 3-star hotel, we book a room, because we have to travel all around, but you need a place to stay. So hospitality means very simple, to make 5-star hotels, 3-star hotels, or you may say the cottages which are lent to the tourist. The last profession which I would like to mention here is entertainment. When I say entertainment, very simple, sometimes we feel that we have to make a documentary of Taj Mahal. We want to make a documentary of Gate of India, or you want to make a documentary of Elephanta Caves, or you want to make a documentary on Red Fort. Now for this, you need to have a good, thorough knowledge of history. And regarding mass media, it includes, you may join a local newspaper and you give importance of that particular place which is of historical importance. And you know, in Times of India, you know, it says that 50 years before, what is there, what has happened, an event related to this particular date, you know. If you have a thorough knowledge of history, you can work in print media. Now, my dear students, these are the various fields where you can have a, you can pursue a professional life. Now, rather than this, what are the other professions that we can pursue by having a good knowledge of history or applied history? The other examples are architects, engineers, historians, archaeologists, museum curator, sociologist, archive management, professionals, legal experts, skilled photographers. Of course, this is just a representative list. The help of the experts from many more fields is required. These experts need to have a good, adequate knowledge of the ancient sites, the historical backgrounds of structural remains and artifacts. Projects in the field of applied history can create various opportunities for these professionals. Now, my dear students, I would like to conclude this lesson by saying that the role of applied history in public training programs for understanding the importance of history, for creating social awareness regarding the conservation and preservation of our cultural and natural heritage, using knowledge of history for this purpose to enhance professional skill of the people and to develop industrial, commercial field and to carry out preparatory work and plan for effective implementation of history. This is all, my dear students, related to the part 3 of applied history. Thank you.